Next question is from YTEPJ. Can being too dedicated to training and nutrition actually impede progress?
Well, yes, but let's change this for a second. There's dedication.
And there's obsession.
There's obsession, right. In pathology. Yes, with nutrition, they call it orthorexia. This is a real medical term for an eating disorder revolving around the need to always eat perfectly healthy, quote-unquote healthy, where you are obsessing about every calorie and macro, and your food has to be perfect, and it becomes not a benefit to your life but a detriment. Orthorexia is a real thing in the health and fitness space. I've met a few people who I would, and I'm not an expert on this, so I'm not a therapist or a doctor, but I would guess that these people fall in this category of orthorexia, where it's just absolutely insane. Bodybuilders and physique competitors and bikini competitors pre-contest, that's what orthorexia would look like all the time, right? Mm-hmm. That always walking around with the same food, counting everything. Now with training, it becomes obsession. Your life revolves around your workouts. Your workouts are no longer contributing to quality of life. They're now taken away from your quality of life.
Yeah, you can't miss a day out of fear.
Totally.
It's more like that.
And it depresses you, and it ruins your day, and it's just horrible.
Yeah. I would. Isn't there a quote that floats around the fitness space that says something like, the lazy is what referred to the dedicated as obsessive, something along those lines.
Yeah, they try to normalize that.
Right. Yeah, there's something along those lines. I mean, truth, unless we're talking about the, if we exclude the bodybuilding space, right? Like, most people don't fall in this category. Most people are not dedicated enough.
No.
Yeah, the average person, 95%+ of the people listening to this podcast right now, are not dedicated enough. There's a very small percentage of people that I would say fall in the category.
It's like, I don't know. I've been working out for 3 months straight.
Yeah.
I heard on Mind Pump, I don't want to get too
I don't want to get too into it.
I'm going to take a month off.
Yeah. And I think that was great that you said, let's rephrase that, because dedicated to training and nutrition is not going to improve. That's excellent. You should be dedicated to it.
Right.
Like that's a good thing. But obsessive about it is something different. And obsessive means you cannot ever go to it. And here's the thing, too. You can be very dedicated and may look borderline obsessive to somebody else because you have a specific goal. I'm sure there was plenty of people that thought I was obsessive when I had a goal in mind, when I was going to go from the guy in the worst shape of his life to the best shape of his life and then to try and compete on stage and then to try to go become pro. That was a fucking serious goal that required some serious dedication and consistency for years. Like, I had to do that for, 2.5 years consistently, that maybe somebody else might go, oh, that's obsessive. Well, that might be obsessive to you, but I had set a goal in my mind of what I wanted to accomplish. And in order to achieve that goal, I had to be extremely dedicated to do that.
You also didn't identify with it to the point where you're like, this is me. This is what I am.
Right.
This is who I am.
That's not me at all. In fact, I'm me. Right now it's me. Me is just like a normal physique. I carry myself between 10 and 14% body fat. I can have a weekend. Like, by the way, speaking of that, man, dude, it's amazing how 1 weekend can make me fat, dude. I mean, and not only that, but man, I can't even do the same kind of fun damage I used to do.
What did you do?
So let me tell you some of the things I had. I had peanut M&Ms this weekend. I had gummy bears.
Yum, yum.
I had lobster pasta.
Oh.
I had breakfast burritos.
Oh.
I had Blaze pizza and wine and champagne. All those things. Gut fucked up, bro. Fucked up. Like, just crazy that I can't. I mean, and it's only like, it was like a 2-day hiatus that I decided, you know what? We're out here at the beach. It's like, I'm going to just cut loose and just do my thing. And it's so funny that I think I don't know if it's an age thing or that I consistently try and eat really well most of the time. And so I'm just more aware now.
More aware.
I wonder that. Like, was I this, like, in 25, was that shit? Was I just.
I just drank Pepto back then to just deal. Oh yeah, it's happening again.
And you know what? What I think happens is I think the adaptation process happens faster. Like, you know, when you're or like when what I notice is this. Like by day three, you know, I remember telling Katrina, I'm like laying there and I'm like, man, everything that we can get right now, food wise, like none of it sounds good to me. I just want like a big salad. Like that's all I was telling her. Like I want like a big salad, something that just fresh, fibrous, easy on my stomach. Where everything else just sounds like it's going to make my gut worse. But what I also noticed was by day three, even though I continue to eat this way, it becomes less and less offensive. And I think that if what happens to us when we were younger is we ignore those original signs.
Totally.
You push through it. Yeah. And then if I were to keep eating that way for a week, I'd probably totally adapt to it. Totally. And then I'd be totally fine.
Totally. We have a friend who we were talking to, and we were talking about bowel movements and, you know, the healthy bowel movements. She's like, you guys poop every day? And I'm like, yeah. Yes. And she's like, I've pooped like 2 or 3 times a month max. I'm like, say what? And she's like, oh, I've always been like
that. So if I squeeze you right now, it's probably
shit. Like, I've always been that. She's like, I've always been that way. This is just how I've always been. So it's normal. And I'm like, it's not. I said, you're used to it because you always do that. But no, you need to be going to the bathroom every single day.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I think that's what it is. I think now I'm so much more aware of that. And I think to myself, like, damn, dude, in the past, I would just push through this.
Yeah.
Until it started to feel better and then my body adapt to it. And then, like, you know, fast food and all that shit would just be normal in the gut.
Yeah. Well, okay. So back to the question. I want to make a point here with this. And I brought this up on a previous podcast, but there was this big study that came out of Harvard, and it echoed many other studies that talk about the same thing. And it talked about the health effects of good and bad relationships on your body and on your health. Okay. And they found in these studies that having bad relationships, so a shitty relationship with your husband or wife, or loneliness, not having lots of friends or whatever, was as bad for your health as smoking 15 cigarettes every single day.
I remember you read that. Okay. Fascinating.
It actually, and having good relationships, having good people around you, people that you have meaningful, close relationships with, including spouses and all that stuff, was more positive for your health on its own when compared to exercise or diet when they're compared on their own. That's how big of an impact it has on your health.
Yeah.
So the reason why I'm bringing that up is there's a lot of people especially in the fitness space, because we're talking about this obsession with training and nutrition. There's a lot of people who are so obsessed with training and nutrition that they do so at the expense of relationships with the people around them. And they justify it by saying it's good for their health.
Mm-hmm.
The reality is you've traded something that's way more impactful for your health for something that now has become bad for your health.
Yeah.
So sure, you work out every day and you never miss a day and you count every calorie and you're obsessed about nutrition. But the fact that you're obsessive about it and you feel bad about yourself probably because you're so obsessed, and the fact that you lose relationships because you're probably not going out, you probably can't get, you know, you probably obsess so much about your workouts and nutrition that you don't hang out with very many people or surface relationships, so you have bad relationships. It's worse for your health.
Yeah, it's hard for me to put a negative connotation to the word dedicated. I think that you nail it with obsessive. Like obsession's a totally different mindset, I think, towards the same goal. And so, like, being dedicated means you're including people, you know, and it's part of your core value. So, like, you're maintaining your core value, but being obsessed is by all means necessary and, like, burning the world around me. That's how I look at it.
Yes, and I'll tell you what, I've been on, you know, I've tiptoed this line. Workouts for me, I could say I was obsessive about them for a little while. And I'll tell you what happens when you're obsessed about your workouts. You don't listen to your body very well. It's 100%. Like, if I'm working, I am going to work out today no matter what. I've made myself sicker many, many times where I go into the gym and I've got a cold. And I know, I would always tell a client not to work out. But for me, no, I'm working out. Now it turns into a worse cold or an infection. I've hurt myself as a result. So no, yes, being too dedicated, or also known as, forget the dedicated, obsessed about work and nutrition, 100% will impede your progress.